Welcome to the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. It's day four of the speed skating competition, and in this session, we'll be featuring the women's and men's team pursuits. Six laps for the women, eight for the men. Teams of three skaters will each take turns at the front of a train, sharing the work whilst maintaining aerodynamic efficiency around this 400 meter oval. But it is a race against the clock where the fastest trio will claim the gold medal. We are ready to go for the women's team pursuit final. Norway up first to set the benchmark. The women's team pursuit event here at the World University Games of 2023 in Lake Placid is finally underway. So coming around the final bend to complete their six laps, 2.4 kilometers in total, and they split up, fan out, and sprint to the line. It will be the third athlete that crosses the line that sets the time. And they've set a 34.10, a 3:34.10. Not a bad benchmark set by Norway. Pair number three in the women's team pursuit, Canada versus Japan. Clean start. Japanese getting into rhythm really fast here. Start looking at the split times early doors here, because fancy these two teams will want to get out to a good lead, and indeed they have. Japan just edging it slightly through the 200. And Canada just getting faster and faster, as are Japan. Gotta think that this is now a race for the medals. Both teams will want to put down big times. Japan getting ever so fast, ever so slightly faster now, closing the gap on the Canadians, but the Canadians are still way, way, way in the lead. Nearly 5 seconds, or at least 6 seconds, actually. Now 8 seconds up on the best time set so far. Oh, and a fall from the Canadians. They were going so well, but they've crashed out here, and things now open up for the Japanese team. They still need to put down a big time, but what disappointment for Canada. They are back up on their feet, but as you can see, they're skating through here, but they're not going to be anywhere near the time. Here come Japan in the background. Japan need to stay focused here. They can't afford to make a mistake. Canada going so well, but Japan have got to forget about it and just get themselves around as fast as they possibly can. Canada setting a time, clearly. A bell for the Japanese team, and they're still three up on the best time. So Kazakhstan with the best time so far. Japan split up across the line. Canada get a split. They've still got another 200 meters to go. Japan crossing the line, maybe more than that, depending how long they were down for. Japan, though, blow up in the final 400. And it looks to me like Kazakhstan are still going to hold the lead. I wonder if the fall from Canada put them off. Well, good on Canada for setting a time here. A long way off the top time, but well, you can't recover from a fall in the team pursuit. The Japanese going so strong, looking so good, getting faster and faster, but look what happens to Canada. They were absolutely miles ahead. And then I think the error, oh, well, it looked like a double error, I think, for Canada at first. I think it was Laurie Kea that just had a little stumble. But then in the end, the slip at the front was what cost the Canadians. So the information being fed out not only to me and therefore to you and to the captions that are on your screen, but also to the teams and the coaches here and all the officials needs to be absolutely spot on. So when it looked like Japan had actually fallen off the Kazakh time, as I said Norway had done, Norway still sit in second place. They went out first on their own, set the time as 3:34.09. At the moment, that time's only been beaten by Japan in the last pairing. So looks like we're back out and ready here. Park Ji-woo with the yellow armband for Korea, white armband for Kong Soo-min, red armband for Park Chai-won. Poland will line up with Kazmarek in the yellow band, Jabrich in the red, and then Wojciech with the white band. So we're off the final pair here. The James Sheffield Olympic Skating Oval. Hunting down a place on the podium in this team event. Poland set the track record here back in March last year with a 3:25.36. I think that's going to be difficult to beat here tonight given the conditions. Perhaps not completely out of reach. Poland, 1.5 seconds up already on the best time set so far. Korea steady, just 0.2 up on the time. So Kazmarek leading the polls from Wojciech Kazmarek. Sorry, Wojciech and Jabrich, I should say. And Kazmarek stays up the front through the top bend. Four seconds up. Park Ji-woo leading the Korean trio. Park Chae-won tucked up in the middle, Kang at the back, but Poland, well, a 5.3 up on the time here. That is Park Ji-woo at the front still for the Koreans. You can see that Poland mean business here. Maintaining the speed. Poland crossing the line and now getting faster and faster. Republic of Korea have stepped up a gear as well. Korea currently sitting in third place. Poland at the top, 6.1 seconds ahead. They've got to maintain this though. And it's interesting that Park Ji-woo and Kazmarek, Olga Kazmarek, have stayed up the front for both their teams. They'll get the bell for the final 400. Poland still up on time here. Japan sitting in second place. Korea, well, they had got up into second, but we're waiting for the split time to come through. They have indeed. Look at Korea as well. Well, we now come up to the final bend for the two teams. Poland split, crossed the line. And what's the final time? It is 4.96 ahead, and the Republic of Korea go 2 seconds clear of the best time. And the last two teams, Poland and the Republic of Korea, have finished top of the pile. Poland taking a 3:21.86, and they have obliterated the track record. Even given the sticky conditions of the track, they have taken 4 seconds out of the track record. Poland win the women's team pursuit. Well, here they are, Kazmarek up the front from Wojciech and Jabrich. They took an early lead, they held it steady, Now, Korea, they were ahead of the time, but they started to drop away from Poland before in the last, well, 600, maybe 800 meters, really putting the hammer down. But in the end, Poland did enough to cross the line with the fastest time here at the World University Games. Olga Kaczmarek, Natalia Jabrich, and Iga Wojtaszek are the champions here in the women's team pursuit. Silver medal goes to Park Ji-woo, Kang Soo-min, and Park Chae-won of Korea. And it was Japan who picked up the bronze medal. Brilliant, brilliant team pursuit here at the James Sheffield Olympic Skating Rink. We're here at the James Sheffield Olympic Skating Rink for the men's team pursuit final. Here is our start list. We go out with Norway and Kazakhstan first, then Republic of Korea paired up with Poland, Japan with Canada. Pair number one in the men's team pursuit final, Norway taking on Kazakhstan. Eight laps of this 400 meter oval here in Lake Placid. So we're underway for the men's team pursuit here at the World University Games of 2023 in Lake Placid. Teams of three form a train for aerodynamic efficiency. Well, you can see that Kazakhstan have blown up a little bit here. Makeyev leading Norway. Probably just haven't got quite enough space to lap the Kazakhs, but what motivation is when you can see your opposing team in front of you, and a finish time of a 4:19.97 for Norway. They paced that really well. Kazakhstan went out a little bit too quick, finishing their lap just now, or their eight laps just now, 20.1 on that split time, but well, you can see it's nearly a 20-second gap between Norway and Kazakhstan. Really solid there from the Norwegians, with Refsas leading the way, and you can see how much they caught up. Norway setting the time here, revised to 4:20.24. So pair number two in the men's team pursuit underway. Korea taking on Poland. Norway have set the time of a 4:20.24 for the eight laps. Poland looking really strong. But it's Korea who's taken the early lead, only by a tenth of a second, or just under a tenth of a second, actually. But this could be a really fast time by these two. Let's not forget, Poland have got the track record here. Very efficient looking Polish team. They switch around in the Korean team, and it's Chung Yang-hoon who's gone up front, sharing load. Koreans coming around the top bend. It's fantastic, isn't it? They're both the teams going so strongly. There's Nalecki now leading the Polish train, but look, this time is being smashed to pieces here. Now, can they keep up the pace? And the Koreans make another switch for their leader, and Park Sang-yoon goes up the front for the Korean team, and they just slip back into that line of three absolutely beautifully. Aren't going to have a change from lead to back. And building both teams here, but Korea with the edge at the moment. The Polish team still have Nalewski at the front. Make another switch. It's likely to be Petrovsky who takes the lead. And sticking with Park Sang-yung at the front, Korea leading the times at the moment. Looking so solid now. Will they make another switch as they come through this next bend? Korea stay with their leader. Park Sang-yung happy to push at the front. Poland now starting to put the foot down. So Poland just shy by 7 seconds, or just under 7 seconds. Nalewski still holding the front line for the Poles. So the bell goes. The Koreans crossing nearly 11 seconds ahead of the Norwegian team. Poland also leading the Norwegians, but in second place behind the Korean team. This is a strong trio here, and it's a good time as well. Park Sang-yung pressing, and the Poles now making a switch by the looks of things, or they've just split apart. The Koreans can see them in their sights. And at 11:25, quicker than 11:25 seconds quicker than Norway. Republic of Korea go across the line. Did Poland blow up? They did a little bit, but they have picked up second spot provisionally. A provisional time of 4:17.19. But this Korean team looked super from the start. They got into their rhythm quickly. They made very quick changes to the leaders and got back into the train super fast, really efficient. 4:09.62 set by the Koreans. They sit top of the pile of the men's team pursuit. So pair number three, the final pair going out, Japan versus Canada. So we're underway. The final two teams going for a podium place here at the 2023 World University Games, the winter edition in Lake Placid. Lake Placid becoming the first city to host two editions of these games. In Canada, coming out of the blocks super fast, breaking the 200 meter split, fastest of all. They're chasing a time set by the team from the Republic of Korea, a new track record, in fact, of a 4:09.62, beating the previous record by nearly 4 seconds. So these two teams are going to have to come at this one pretty fast right from the start. Just dropping off the pace set by the Koreans, but let's not forget, Korea did start to just seize up a little bit in the middle phase of the race before exploding at the end. And snow's coming down a lot harder now, but it's not sticking to the track is what the technical people have told me, and that's why they're able to race safely. The Canadians at the last bit were in second place. They remain in second place, and Japan have moved up from fifth into third at that particular split time. Got to be careful about this because these two teams will pace themselves ever slightly differently. So Yamada leading for the Japanese team, and Marcotti up the front for the Canadians. breaking a hole through, and you see how close they are. There's just not even 2/10 between them at the moment. Still sitting in second and third, but Japan going ever so slightly faster now and have moved into second spot. Now it's Arito at the front for the Japanese team. He's taken up responsibilities there. Japan still have Marcotti up the front. Blowing hard, these two teams now. Japan have taken the split lead for sure. But just a thousandth of a second up on the Canadians now, who've moved into second place. So Canada just dropping off a tiny bit. We come up to split number 13 and a final lap. Japan 0.6 up. Canada have just dropped away, but still sit in third place. One to go here in Lake Placid. Now, can this Japanese team maintain the speed they've got? Canada have just dropped off a tiny bit.
The team from Japan looks strong as they work their way around.
Can they push for the line here? Arito still up the front for Japan, 1.38 up. And they come around the last bend. This is going to be exceptionally close. And Canada have blown up, and look at that, Japan have done it. They've beaten the track record set in the last round by Korea by 2.61 seconds, and a 4.07.01 is enough to take the gold medal here in the men's team pursuit. Canada just started to blow up with about 700 meters to go. Here is Canada at the start. They look so sweet, so in tune with each other. But the Japanese team also looked solid. A little slip there from Tanigaki. But look at them racing to the line. They still had enough to sprint over the line, break the track record for the second time this evening, and to complete the run that we've had here in the James Sheffield Oval at these championships, with the teams and the track records being beaten in every single session. Japan confirmed with a 4.07.52 with the gold medal. Korea sitting in second place from the Japanese. Both teams breaking the track record. And Canada's David LaRue, Joshua Tellezin, and Hubert Marcotti, who complete the podium for the Canadians. Japan at the top of the pile with the gold medal here in Lake Placid.